Okay, I'm gonna show you one of my tricks. I just heard a black and white warbler, and I wanna demonstrate how I would call one in to get a look at it. This is something you wanna use responsibly. There he is, I'm singing again. It's not really ethical to torment the birds, and I don't harass them often in the same area, but if you want to get good pictures and get a good view of these birds, it's something you want to use in moderation. So I'm going to play the black and white warbler sounds and show you how quickly they'll come in for a visit. Usually they respond. You can hear girls drumming. Play it again. So if he doesn't come quickly, usually I'll change up the call. I'm listening. Here he comes. I can see him. He's coming in now. I can hear him. It's a black and white warbler. They always fly past you to triangulate where you're at. So I'll hold still and he'll fly into this tree right beside me. Just a second. Here he comes, right back. So he flew past. They're doing some sort of song and dance. Should come in closer. That's not pretty close. There he is. There he is. There he is. There's your black and white warbler. Just call them in. Yep, that's how you get a good view of them. I said use this in moderation. I'm just gonna enjoy them for a second, then I won't bug them again. Absolutely beautiful. That's how you see birds in this country. Beautiful. So I use the Merlin app to identify the sounds. And then I use the sound IDs to call them, and then I use my camera to get a good shot. And I'm glad I got to demonstrate that and show you how it works. So that was the black and white warbler. And clear view of the country, some of the beautiful birds in our neighborhoods, and share photography and share the love of the beautiful birds in creation.